a privilege. I volunteered my services as an educator. Then, as an 18-year-old, the work I did was a necessity. I was an automotive dismantler and a trooper in the Australian Army Reserve. Now I live in a housing commission place. Then I shared a unit with my dad, which was really just a resting place where I didn't have anywhere else to crash. Now my social life is limited because I can't get into any of the places I want to go to. Then I was out speed skating, partying, just generally having a good time. Now my friends are my carers. Then my friends weren't paid. I was the life of the party, it had to be cool to hang around me. Nowadays my moves are all planned, like an intricate ballet move. Then I used to just rock up and let it happen. Now I'm a member and a supporter of a rugby league team. Go the Roosters! Now the only sport I do is in relation to my recovery. Then I played baseball as an infielder. I was a wicketkeeper in cricket, a second rower in rugby league. And I also played on the wing in Australian rules. Then I drove touring cars and even qualified for a 1988 James Hardy Ferrari, the longest touring car race in Australia. Now I can watch it every year and just dream about driving again. Then, while travelling home on a train, I was approached by a gang who wanted money from me. And my general purpose army boots. They would have had to kill me to get my boots. So I gave them the contents of my wallet, but they wanted more. There was five of them against just little old me and my army training. On solid ground, I reckon I would have had a chance. They launched me out of the moving train just as it was coming into Campsie Station. I was found 26 hours later. I had a traumatic brain injury. I suffered fractures to C6, C7 in my neck and fractures in my backbone. I had eggshell fractures to the back of my head, causing left side paralysis, side damage, and hearing loss. But hey, ladies, I've gone through all this, but I've kept me looks. In hospital, they attempted to put my head back together. My head's still rough with guts. I'm thinking I should have gone to a panel beater and spray painter. I moved hospitals for rehab. I don't think the rehab I received was enough or adequate. I heard some nurses talking about a nursing home, so I thought I'd give that a go. After the first night I was there, I realized it was the biggest mistake I'd ever make. The nursing home wasn't a home. It was more like a detention centre for old people. A place to die, and I wasn't ready to die. I still got at least another 100 years in me. Now at 45, I live on my own by choice. I'm independent and I can concentrate on walking again and recovery of my arm as well. After what I've been through, I reckon I'm an expert when it comes to rehabilitation. I believe we need facilities adequate enough to give the people with ABIs the appropriate rehab. It's been 27 years since my accident. I still do physio, hydro and gym to build up my strength, because I refuse to give up on my dream of walking again. I'll stop rehab when my toes are pointing to the sky. Now I know my disabilities. I can see clearly now. Not everyone has the ability to see themselves the way I see myself. Brain injury can occur anytime, anywhere, to anyone. It's almost as easy as sneezing. Don't feel sorry for me, 'cause I am above average.